This video tutorial I will explain how to send a message to the queue of RabbitMQ, which is running on Amazon EC2 instance. And also we will see how to receive message from queue of RabbitMQ, which is running on Amazon EC2 instance. Here you can see Amazon AWS console. Here I have started this particular AWS instance and copy this IPv4 address, and using Putty software I am logging to the Amazon EC2 server, and it is successfully logged in. Using this command I am starting the RabbitMQ server, and RabbitMQ server is started successfully. Copy this DNS name . Here you can see the RabbitMQ UI. Username password is guest. Here you can see the client 1, which creates the message and sends the message to the queue, which is nothing but producer. And here you can see the client 2, which consumes the message from the queue, which is nothing but consumer. And once the message is consumed, the client 2 will acknowledge us back to the queue. And in this example, we are using a queue of RabbitMQ. And for client 1, we have written message sender.java, and for client 2, we have written message receiver.java. We will see the example now. Here you can see pom.xml file, and in this file, I have included the dependency of RabbitMQ and SL4j. Here I have defined the class message sender. And here I have defined the queue name as message_queue, and here I am creating a factory object, and then I am setting a host and port number, and host name we have to give it as DNS name. This DNS name we have to copy and put it here, and port number is 5672, which is default port which RabbitMQ will listen. And using a new connection method of factory object, I am creating the connection object, and using a create channel method of connection object, I am creating the channel object. Then using a queue declare method of channel object, I am binding the queue name with channel. Then here I have declared the message. The message is hello world, then the current date. Then using a basic publish method of channel object, I am sending the message to the queue. Then I am just displaying the what message I have sent to the queue. I ran this program and I got a connection timeout error because this port number is not public. So we have to do some configuration in Amazon EC2 server. and we have configured the port 5672 as a public port. Now we will check. Now I am running this program again. And this message is successfully sent to the queue of RabbitMQ. We can check in the RabbitMQ UI. And here you can see one message is there. Click on queue. And here you can see message underscore queue is created. That is the name we have given here. Click on this. In that one message is there, total one message is there. Click on get message. And this is the message we have sent that you can see here. Suppose you want to delete or purge the message, click on delete. And the queue itself deleted. Currently there is no queue is there. I am running again. Running again. And running again. I have sent three messages. We will check in the queue. And here you can see message queue. There are three messages are there. Click on this. There are three messages are there. Next we will see how to consume these messages using a Java program. Here I have defined the class message receiver, and here I have defined the queue name as message underscore queue, and inside main method I am creating a connection factory object, and in connection factory object I am setting the host and port number. Host we have to give the DNS name, and default port is 5672 where RabbitMQ will listen, and using a new connection method of factory object I am creating the connection object. Then using create channel method of connection object I am creating the channel object. Then using queue declare method of channel object I am binding the queue name with channel, and this piece of code will consume the message from the queue, and it will keep on running, and whenever queue has any messages it will consume. I am running this program, and here you can see the output. There were three messages there, and all the three messages has been consumed. And currently there is zero messages. All three messages were consumed. And we will send one more message. And this message has been sent. And we will switch to message receiver console. And here you can see the recent message. We will send one more message. Switching to message receiver output console, and one more message also received. you can get a Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more, and here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.